Hello everyone, warm welcome to your My Investment Mastery series, and today we are in episode 34th of talking about mutual funds. Today's topic is what are sectoral funds or thematic funds and should I invest in them? So as we already know, there are so many kinds of mutual funds and a lot of us are not even aware of those types of funds. So today we are going to talk about this one type and look at if it is worth investing in. So that's the big purpose of today's investment mastery. Hey Prerna, hi Sheetal, good morning. Who else is around? Please acknowledge your presence. Yes Prerna, absolutely. Electricity is back, Bijli is back, and I am here to create fun, to educate you. Okay, while we wait for people to come, let's begin. So sectoral or thematic funds, whenever you notice, I'm looking down, I'm looking at my notes that I've made for all of you. So sectoral or thematic funds, they are a type of mutual fund. That's number one. Number two, they invest in businesses that operate in a sector, industry or sector. So sectoral funds, certain thematic funds means they are investing in businesses which are in that particular sector. I'm giving you examples of sectoral funds. They are banking and finance, infrastructure, real estate, MNCs, technology, pharma. So these are the kinds of sectoral funds or thematic funds. So they are basically in one industry, same industry, and the downside of such funds is they lack diversification. So because you're investing in one sector, all the companies within that sector, so what the downside is? Diversification. There isn't enough diversification in such funds. The risk levels because of that is high, because there is not enough diversification. And such funds, it is mandatory for them to invest in a particular sector. Like there is a minimum mandate for them, around 70-80% of their funds, they must invest in a particular industry. So how you will find such funds in the market? Like asset management company's name followed by technology fund. So AMC name technology fund or AMC name pharma fund. So there are such funds which exist in the market already. So there are different types of sectoral or thematic funds. Like number one is a banking fund. So they are investing in the finance or the banking sector. Then there is the infrastructure fund, which is investing in infrastructure companies. Pharma fund, investing in pharma companies. Technology, investing in IT, ITES firms. FMCG, so they are investing in mostly fast moving consumer goods, MNCs, energy, PSU, consumption, automobile. So these are all different types of sectoral or thematic funds that you can invest in. And now the real question, should you be investing in them? So for that, I am looking at the advantages of such funds and the disadvantages of sectoral funds or thematic funds. And before I get into that, let me welcome my people. Hey Rajeshwari, Seema, Lit, Ridhma, Rohini, Sneha, Amrita, welcome. Sunil, okay, welcome. So should I invest in sectoral or thematic funds? So beginning with the advantages. There is a high likelihood of this fund outperforming if that sector does extremely well. So if this sector that the sectoral fund belongs to, if it does extremely well, then there is a very high likelihood that that you will generate great returns. So that's one. Like one of the pharma funds, like we all know, when the first wave came, pharma companies were the best companies that generated the returns. So there are certain pharma funds which have done extremely well in this period. So there is a higher probability of such funds outperforming the market, but then you don't know when that happens. So that's the biggest advantage of such funds. The disadvantage is that they lack diversification. So there is lack of diversification because you are investing in one kind of companies within that sector or theme. Number two, there is higher risk. The third disadvantage is that maybe you need to time this, because every sector will not perform well at all times. So there are different cycles that each sector is in. So the critical part is that as intelligent investors, knowledgeable investors, can we time them? And if we can time them, then there is a higher probability of us making money. And well, I don't think that anybody can time the market. There are limited options for the fund managers. So fund managers say it's a pharma fund, so they have limited options to invest only in pharma companies. And so that also takes the risk high and makes the task difficult for the fund managers. So those are the disadvantages. The risk is high, lack of diversification is there. There are limited options available for the fund managers. So what I believe is that it is extremely difficult for anybody to time the market, no matter how knowledgeable investor you are. But see, nobody can see the future. Nobody would have known that coronavirus is coming and pharma companies are going to hit the roof. So it's very, very difficult to predict such things. And I don't think anybody can time the market. So I really don't think there is a point in investing in sectoral or thematic funds unless there is a certain need that such funds are fulfilling as far as reaching your financial goals are concerned. So that's my take on the sectoral funds or the thematic funds. Time for what you guys are learning, doing, getting. Hey Kanika, good to have you. Srija, Sunil, is it better to invest in good stocks? Yes, I am a ferocious stock investor. There are many, many videos, Sunil, that you will find on our Women on Wealth page. So check them out. I talk a lot about stocks and mutual funds and all the modern types of investments. Guys, start typing. What are you learning? What are you understanding? What are you getting? And I see a lot of people around, but they've not shared that they are here. So if you are here, do acknowledge your presence. It builds wonders. It takes wonders to build a community. So acknowledge it. Prerna, you would rather invest in stocks than these funds. Okay, what makes you say that, Prerna? Like, what makes you choose stocks over such mutual funds? Hey Vani, welcome. Panchami, got that, Prerna. You've studied and researched your stocks. Brilliant. Rohini, there's high risk and high volatility in such funds. Yes. Sure, go for it. Invest in stocks. What else? What else are we getting, understanding? Scope of diversification is less as the investment is in a particular sector only. Yes, brilliant, Amrita. Kanika, high risk, limited options available for fund managers, less diversification. So nobody knew corona would come and pharma funds will be a hit. So nobody knows when it is time to invest in sectoral funds. So investing in such funds may not be the preferred choice. Got that. Kanika is saying she jotted down what she heard and understood. Absolutely. So we are your money school for women, and like in school, you make notes and learn. Exactly, that's the space here for women. Hey Asha, welcome. Good to see you after a long time. Rajeshwari, thematic funds, sectoral funds are high risk, less diversification. We can't predict their performance. Sheetal, a new type of fund that is not commonly made available to the common women. It is good to know, so it can be safely avoided. Brilliant. Prerna, it is not possible to time the market and there is less diversification. So stocks are my choice. Got that, Prerna. On this note, guys, closing the live. Any of you who would like to share this video, did you create value for yourself? And would you like to share this video among women in your life so you could share as your Facebook story, on your Facebook posts, where else, on WhatsApp? So could you guys do that? Could you guys spread the word about Women on Wealth? K. Ridhima, thematic funds are cyclical, which is difficult to manage. Hence, they are risky. Yes, brilliant. Sunil, should we wait for the correct time to invest? Nobody knows when that correct time is. So, don't bother to time this market. It's not worth it. It's really, really not worth it. Sheetal has shared the video. Thank you so much, Sheetal, Amrita, Prerna. Who else is jumping in? I know a lot of you have come in and taken value. It is time for you to push for progress for other women. So, Shirija, thank you for sharing. Got that. We acknowledge that you are standing with us in this journey for financial education for women. Rohini is saying, thank you for another informative session. Have a great day ahead. Sure. You too, Rohini. On this note, I'm closing this live. Do share this video, do comment, do like, love. If you're watching later as well, I always keep a tab on which of my investors are learning and sharing. Loads of love. Take charge, stay safe. See you tomorrow in the decoding of the Economic Times newspaper.